So now that we've established the rules for calculating formula weights and moles and Avogadro's number and everything like that, we can now perform many calculations around these concepts. So the first example problem we're going to look at is how many moles of N2O are present in 100.0 grams of N2O. We now know that one mole of N2O is going to equal 2 times 14.00 grams plus 1 times 16.00 grams or 44.00 grams of N2O. This is how much 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd N2O molecules is going to weigh. So if we have 100.0 grams of N2O, we can now set up a conversion factor problem and use dimensional analysis. Our given unit is grams of N2O, and the desired unit we want is moles of N2O. We know that 44.00 grams of N2O is equal to 1 mole of N2O. So using the numerator denominator form, we can say that 100.0 grams of N2O times 1 mole of N2O over 44.00 grams of N2O. We cancel out the grams, we're left with moles of N2O, and this gives us 2.273 moles of N2O. Keeping in mind the rules for significant figures, we have 4 significant figures. We do the multiplication. Everything in here has 4 significant figures as well. So 100 grams of N2O is going to be 2.273 moles.